algorithm analysis. Welcome back to KNearest Neighbors. After we understood what the algorithm does, let's now analyze its operation. You'll find there's more than meets the eye. Choosing who to learn from. The KNearest Neighbors algorithm is a supervised machine learning algorithm that learns from the data points we identify as the right points to learn from. The challenge, therefore, is not to draw the conclusions, but to decide who should teach us and how. Implementation. The number of nearest neighbors, k, must be provided. It must be known before running the algorithm. In many circumstances, this is not the case. Look at this chart. If k is too small, our classification will be sensitive to noise. If k is too large, the neighborhood may include points from other classes. That's an important issue, and as I said, we will come back to it later on. K could be relative, meaning we can set it to be a certain percentage of the training set, say 10% of the classified data points, or only those data points that are within a certain distance, a certain radius, and so on. In any case, we still need some sort of a threshold to decide who to learn from. A distance metric is, of course, at the core of the algorithm. As discussed in the previous unit about k-means, we can use various formulas, manipulate and adapt them to our needs. Complexity. In its naive implementation, this is a very slow algorithm. Computing the distance of the unclassified data point to all the other data points in the training set could be an exhaustive process. In addition, identifying the k data points with the shortest distance is also quite a complex computation. However, we can always choose to use only a sample of the training set instead of all its data points. In many cases, that would make a good approximation of the true result. That is, of course, if we are careful in balancing speed and accuracy. This sample could be chosen randomly or using a certain heuristic or statistical test. We just need to ensure that the data points in our sample are a good representation of the entire training set. Mathematical accuracy. Now, this is where things get tricky. So one element, as we said, is knowing k. Another is the balance between speed and accuracy. But much deeper than those, by definition, this algorithm makes decisions based on neighbors or neighborhoods. This image demonstrates what would the decision of each combination of values for sodium and potassium would be. This may be considered as very evidence-based, and that's good. But can we know for sure that these neighborhoods are correct? Let's see. First, the borders of the neighborhoods are defined by the data points that we have in the training set, and by them alone. This means that the properties of how we constructed this training set may influence the decision a great deal. Specifically, have we covered all the important regions in the virtual space of possible new data points that we will face? But even more so, how well do they represent the true biological mechanism that underlies the phenomena that we observe? Well, clearly, we could not inject any knowledge about the biological mechanism to the system, even if we had one. And many times we have. It could be complete knowledge or just partial clues. But anyway, this algorithm relies solely on raw data points. In summary, this method is very elegant, straightforward, and many times produces very good results. Here's another quote that perfectly describes its rationale. When I see a bird that walks like a duck and swims like a duck, and quacks like a duck, I call that bird a duck. But I'd like to end with two concerns that are very relevant and common, specifically in medicine. A person's medical situation is influenced by so many different factors, many different types of factors. The data sources that are relevant for classification or prediction could be very heterogeneous. For example, some data sources could be numerical, some continuous and some discrete. Others could be textual or visual, fusing everything together, reducing these rich representations into some sort of numerical-based neighborhoods can be too coarse and not practical. More importantly, in medicine, it is, of course, important to make the right decision, the right classification. But we also want to understand why. What is the reason? What is the explanation for that decision? KNN is considered a black box algorithm. That means that it doesn't infer a rule or a model that a human, not a computer, can read and understand. As a doctor, would you feel comfortable in making safety-critical, life-saving decisions without understanding the biological mechanism? Will your patients feel comfortable hearing that they should go under a certain procedure just because it worked for the majority of their mathematical K-nearest neighbors? Later on, we will see another technology called decision trees that can handle these two concerns. For now, I just hope you see how even simple algorithms that seem so straightforward can have so many deceptive elements. So, don't let them fool you.